So you're Chatty
Cathy. I'm Chatty the doll. I am the original doll. You pull my string and I talk. Everybody knows who Tony Curtis is because some like it hot.
Hey, I'm here with Regina King. Regina's a well-known actress who's played in many movies. And
name one.
Okay. She's been in, she played in the movie Ray. She was the woman who was the other woman. She could have been the wife, but she could have been the wife, but she didn't want to read for that part. She felt more identified with the other woman.
Oh,
is that
okay.
True?
I did
my homework. Okay. So are you having fun today?
Yes, I am.
Do you expect to win?
No. They're serious. I mean, like, serious. I mean, they have their own boots, their own gloves, guns.
Wait, you mean the other celebrities have their own guns?
No. Oh. But there's two other teams out here.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes, professional
team. Thank you for educating me.
You see?
I'm here with Tashina Arnold, and that's a mouthful.
Right.
You know why? Because her name is spelled T-I-C-H-I-N-A. And wouldn't you think that's Thai China?
I know. Okay, but my dad had to be fancy, so he spelled it. He named me, and he spelled it that way. But my name doesn't mean anything.
Mine's Kathy, and it doesn't mean anything either.
Really? Kathy doesn't mean anything?
Actually, it means pure one.
Oh,
so that's me.
She's a pure white girl.
He juiced everything. He juiced dandelions from the yard. He juiced carrots. He juiced anything he could find that wasn't poisonous, he would juice. And he had this garlic, and he took all these cloves and put them in the juicer, and then he just went, let me borrow your cup. I have no germs because I'm the host.
How did you choose this design?
I decided to go ahead and go with fruits and flowers. Basically, fruits and flowers only exist to attract pollinators.
So are you looking for a pollinator? Is that what you're saying?
Perhaps.
People use voice changers, you know, just disguise
their
voice.
Hi, my name is Kathy.
Exactly. On cell phones, you know, just to see, you know, like, you want to meet me tonight?
10 big lies that you write about. Which one do you think is the most significantly important?
This is what amazed me, Kathy. Was I was researching this book, going all the way back to the beginnings of American civilization, people are predicting the end of American civilization. 1645, we're so morally bad, bankrupt. We're finished. The point about this is, look, abortion is down.
Right.
Divorce is down. Crime is down dramatically. Drug use is down dramatically.
So it's the media, isn't it?
Well,
we're
is.
Being saturated by all this negative stuff and
always,
we're believing it.
Always.
This is another contraption.
Which looks like, let me just say for the women out there, like you work for an OBGYN.
Yeah. Well, it's like, make sure you do a nice rim right around.
Right,
the
right
bottom.
Around the top here. If you're Jewish, you could do it on the bottom.
Why? What does that mean? Okay. Do you circumcise buttholes? <buttholes? laughs>
If you've got a beautiful girl on the back of your bike and she's got her arms around you, there's not a better feeling in the world.
Well, I was going to say, I wouldn't mind two women on the back of my bike. That would be okay, too.
And the mushrooms will taste like they've been
cooked. And again, let me just reiterate, it has not been cooked.
Not at all.
Right.
Never.
Okay. And how long did it take to prepare this? How many minutes?
5 minutes.
5 minutes. See, and the busy mom, she can just go raw.
That's right. And make the kids do. The kids can make the noodles and mom can make the
yes. Do you work out with men?
No, just.
Why? Why don't you work out with him?
No, man.
All my zone.
How did you break yours?
Yes, that means I was a very busy beauty queen that year. Your crown is not broken by the end. If you haven't repaired it, you weren't doing your job.
We're obsessed with looking young.
I don't want to look 60 until I'm 80. I want to be on the Jetsons and be flying in my flying saucer at 60 years old.
But you're looking 40.
Oh, yeah, looking 40.
You were married. You were in the situation. You were lacking emotionally. There was this big gaping hole in one regard. But then everything else was, like, great.
Right.
So you leave the situation. Now you're getting that one thing filled. And then the person, maybe the other guys that you dated, have the huge, bigger hole. Every 7 seconds, a guy is thinking a sexual thought. And I just read, and that's just bull. Okay, it's bull. I read that the Kinsey Institute frequently asked question is how many actually are. And 54% of men have a sexual thought once a day, maybe twice, but all day long, 7 seconds. Oh, okay, I'm going to have a sexual thought. Now, no, there's no way. They would never accomplish anything.
The women march off to the restroom together. Yeah. You ever see a guy says, oh, I have to go to the bathroom. You want to come with me, Bob?
I would wonder, are you tapping toes? The girl wants the romance.
The girl wants the romance.
Yeah.
See, but we're talking to you.
It was the result of the romance.
See the language.
Right, see?
It's the same word, but it's communicating something different at the same time
that
you
and
me.
If you're going to get married, if you don't have commitment, then I don't see how really anybody can ever stay together.
Almost 80% of first-time marriages will stay together until one of the people dies.
You know what I love about your pencil drawings? Am I calling that right?
Pencil
drawings?
Yeah, pencil. Uh-huh.
Is how alive the drawings look.
We waited for hours for Tiger Woods to show up, and he finally starts making his way. And by this time, everybody who was there knew about this drawing, and everyone was rooting for me to get it autographed. Tiger, look, Tiger, look, look. And he looked, and he waved, and smiled, and just kept going. And we just go, what? But we never asked him to sign it. Joe Montana.
I love Joe Montana.
Okay, I drew Joe.
I want to hear this story.
Okay. All these football guys were charging people a ton of money to have a football thrown to them. I said, hey, Joe, I'll throw you a pass, and I won't even charge you. And so he starts laughing. I always thought you put your fingers like this on the football. And I tried to throw it, and I love to throw baseballs. So that's my thing. And I threw it, and it did this little twirl thing, and I went, oh, no, how could I do that? And so he said, no, take your index finger and put it at the top, and then grab with your thumb onto this, whatever these are called, strings, and then throw it. And so I did. I got about, I don't know, 13 passes with him. And by the last one, it was okay. Tune in every Sunday at 6:30 on Channel 54 for Chatty Cathy. Aloha.